สวัสดีครับ Hi everyone กสิทธิ์ พิรมยา once again I would like to speak more on Thai politics I would like to begin by recalling that in 1932 about 90 years ago exactly you know there came the end of the absolute monarchy in Thailand and Thailand became a constitutional monarchyWith the objective of becoming an open democratic society through parliamentary system, through elections and competition between political parties and their respective candidates. But for the past 90 years, most of the time, what we have seen on the political arena of Thailand is protests and military intervention and coup d'etats.Okay, so we, I think, have been having more generals assuming the post of the prime ministership of Thailand rather than any civilian politician. So we are similar to neighboring countries like Myanmar, Pakistan, Turkey, you know, Egypt and so on, or many of the countries in Latin America where life is mostly being, I think, under the...authority of the military establishment. And on top of that, now we have also learned that many generals who staged the coup d'etat, or once they have completed their terms of office, reaching the age of retirement, they continue with their political ambition by setting up political parties. You know, the current one,the major coalition partner of the Thai government under General Prayut Chan Ocha, the main political party, Palang Pracharat, let me repeat, Palang Pracharat, it was being set up a couple of years ago, you know, by some of the generals, using some technocrats and some politicians to do the, I think, administrative, the what you call, layout, the structure of the party, looking for candidates, collecting, selecting candidates, and so on. So that has been quite a tradition in Thai political scene that many generals, you know, especially the army chief or commander-in-chief of the army, you know, usually set up political partiesOn the eve of their retirements, and at the beginning things look very well because they still have a lot of influence and power inside the Thai society and particularly among the armed forces. And surely, with their position or as the head of the coup d'état or the head of political party, there will be many business people, you know, seasoned politicians running to them and so on.To I think work with them, support them, because they still believe that those generals still have the I think the aura, the wealth, and the influence inside the Thai bureaucracy and in the business and academic circle. And at the beginning, the first couple of years, so far so good, things would be running smoothly. The generals, many of the generals after their retirement, becoming.Head of political parties and so on, also became elected Prime Minister of Thailand. And let me jump to today. Today, I think the trio that staged the coup d'etat 6-7 years ago, General Prawit, General Prayut, and General Anupong, the three of them staged the coup d'etat 8 years ago. And since then, under the military government, and 3 years ago, under theelected or same quasi-democratic government, the three generals are still in the government. General Prayut is the prime minister, General Prawit is the deputy prime minister, and General Anupong is the minister of interior. So the past 8 years, the three of them have been holding, I think, important portfolios, especially in the security-related fields and so on.And General Prawit became the, what you call, the leader or the head of the Palang Pracharat Party, which is the main or the core coalition partner of the present government. But after 2 years, up to I think a few months ago, what we have seen is that the grips of the three generals on political on their political party is, I think, sliding down a bit. There have been many infightings, jockeying for position, pressuring General Prayut and General Prawit to give them ministerial posts, and some even left the party to create another party, you know, in order to keep pressuring the three generals, you know, to comply to their wishes or to their political ambition or to their socio-economic interests that come with portfolios and position and so on. So what is happening at the moment for General Prayut, General Prawit, and General Anupong is what had been happening the past 90 years, that when the generals in uniform left their military uniform and assume the leadership of political parties and became ministers in the sort of a democratic setting or semi-democratic setting, their grips on power and their influence and their charisma seems to be fading day by day, and they will be having a difficulty on holding to powers and so on. So I think history keep on repeating itself. And for that matter, when the three generals started to losing the grip on powers and the influence and the charismatic leadership inside the political circle, inside the bureaucracy, and inside the academic and the intellectual world and so on, then the question is, then what would happen? I think either the three generals have to regroup, but to regroup and to get support from political parties and politicians, it is very well known and open fact that you need a lot of money to buy support. And how much money the three generals would keep on having or trying to find in order to get the support of politicians, say 150 politicians or 200 politicians inside the House of Representatives. So there have been rumors, and one of the person that have come out to say that there could be another coup d'etat in Thailand during this year, the year 2022. And the person that has come out in the open to say about the possibility of a coup d'etat is Dr. The leader of Dr. Chomanan, the leader of the Pheu Thai Party, the main opposition party, with the former Prime Minister of Thailand, which everyone know, Mr. Thaksin Shinawat, behind the scene conducting the affairs from his base as a political exile in Dubai. And Dr. Chomanan, the current chair of the Pheu Thai Party, has come out and give a sort of a press announcement a few weeks back that there could be a coup d'etat. Maybe he's not saying this out of wishful thinking. He has been a very seasoned politician, and he must have some inkling of what's going on. And I think what he and I could agree is that, as I have just mentioned, that the three generals, the trio, General Prayut, General Prawit, General Anupong, the three of them are not in full control of the political life and processes of Thailand. And if they could not solve the political problems by a sort of a civilian means, then they might have to recourse to the intervention of the armed forces, which the three of them still have linkages and influence and so on. Because many of the top Army chief, Navy chief, and Air Force, as well as the police forces and so on, they have been subordinate to these three generals 10, 15, or 20 years back, so they still know each other and so on. And from the armed forces' point of view, they would prefer to have a former generals or former bosses, you know, running the show of the country in the government and so on, because they could have the same language of communication. They would be quite uncomfortable to be under the leadership of civilian politicians, civilian prime ministers and so on. So they will be a sort of having a comfort zone to have a former general as the prime minister so that they can relate. Can ask for support on the budget side to get more equipment or to expand the armored forces and so on. And they still have that tacit support to the three generals that I have mentioned. And if things are too difficult, if there is an impasse on the political process of Thailand, maybe the way out that has been quite a tradition in Thailand is to recourse to the intervention of the armored forces. So we cannot dispense that possibility out. And the fact is that the current coup d'etat in Myanmar, the military junta in Myanmar could stand the pressure of the international community, you know, to force them to give back democracy to the Myanmar people. But so far, the international community has been quite weak, and maybe with the sort of a semi-successful story of the Myanmar military junta, maybe some of the Thai generals at the moment might have also similar idea that a political situation, and you know, with parliaments and so on, and political parties running around, running the country, it might not be good for Thailand. It would provide instability. Then why not we do another intervention to pacify the situation, bring stability, and then run the country? It's better than to be, I think, having to deal with many corrupted and self-vested interests, politicians and political parties. But hopefully everyone will have the senses to get together. I have suggested many times and so on, on many occasions in various forums and so on, that General Prayut Chan-o-cha, the Prime Minister, must sit down and talk with and to all the stakeholders of Thailand and find a common way, reach a consensus to find a common goal to push Thailand forward in so many these current challenges forthcoming from the world at large, whether the pandemic, climate change, I think inequality, poverty, and all of this and so on, technological changes. Thailand need to settle its house in order to meet the challenges regionally and globally and move forward as a very competitive nation state. ขอบคุณมากครับ. Thank you very much.